A man died with radioactive material in his body, and then he was cremated. What does this mean? It's pretty common for people with certain types of diseases to get injections of radioactive material into their bodies. And that was what happened in this case. This man had a kind of cancer that doctors were trying to treat, and the medicine they were using to treat it had an isotope in it called lutetium-177. And lutetium-177 is radioactive. Not crazy deadly radioactive, but pretty significant, pretty, you know, dangerous if you're exposed to it over the long term. But what happened was, this man died 2 days after the injection, 5 days later he was cremated, and you know, cremation burns the body and spreads all this material all over the crematory oven. And this was allowed to happen because, you know, there just wasn't really effective communication between the officials in charge of safety with radioactive medicines and, you know, the crematorium. But once it happened, they went and brought Geiger counters, the little machines that check on radioactive activity, to the crematorium, and they found pretty significant radiation at the facility. There was, you know, on the oven itself and, you know, on the different, you know, mechanisms of it, there was pretty significant radiation found. Not so much that would, you know, be deadly immediately, but not something you would want to be exposed to on a day-to-day basis either. And beyond that, the worker who cremated the body, they tested his urine later and they found some radioactive material in his urine that, you know, there wasn't another good explanation for how it got there. Only trace amounts, but still, you know, not something you want to find. And so the good news is there probably wasn't enough radiation here to be any major danger to the public, even to the worker who cremated this body. But the bad news is this kind of thing might be happening all the time. The researchers brought up there really isn't, you know, that much good data on how often, you know, cadavers like this, bodies like this with radioactive medicines inside them are cremated. And if it's happening a lot without anyone noticing, that could be a pretty significant radiation source that crematory workers and members of the public are being exposed to. And, you know, that we try to avoid being exposed to radiation. That's why, you know, if you get an x-ray, you wear lead to cover, you know, all of your body but the part of you that needs to be x-rayed, because radiation isn't good for you. And so, you know, the researchers who, you know, found out about this and published a study on it in JAMA, what they called for was new rules and new regulations designed to sort of keep an eye on people who die with radioactive medicines in their bodies and make sure that they're not unsafely cremated so as to protect the public and people who work in these crematoriums. It's kind of unclear how often this is happening right now, but as, you know, radioactive medicine, you know, continues to be a common aspect of how diseases like cancer are treated, it's probably important that we keep an eye on, you know, what happens to bodies that have radioactive material in them after death. ¶¶